Okay, and we're back. Productivity Shop Slow Jams. And we're going to be talking about the Power Pack features, all the cool things that I like. And then in the next video, we're going to do everything. So that way, if you need a specific thing, you'll be able to find it. Let's get to it. So I went ahead and entered my Power Pack information, and you can get a Power Pack at alfredapp.com. And the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to remove the fallback results. Now, I've already restored my particular settings, so it might look a little different, but I'm going to do Command Space, and I'm going to search for anything. So search for anything. You can see here that since it didn't show up in the default scope, it's going to have some fallback search options. Now, I don't really like the default search options, so in order to change them or remove them, you can go to Alfred Preferences, Command Space, Command Comma, and then go to Features, Default Results, and then Only Show Fallbacks When There Are No Results, and you can set up fallback results here. So I'm going to go ahead and remove the ones that I don't want, and I'm just going to leave the Google one. Cool. Next, I'm going to go to File Search in the Features menu, and I'm going to change some of the settings here. So for result limit, I always like it to be the maximum. And then here, there's some other settings that you can use. And then another setting that I like to change is run Apple scripts instead of opening. So if I run an Apple script, I'm going to go ahead and write a quick one. So now if I run this Apple script, test.scpt, it's going to go ahead and run the script when I push enter. So there it goes. Now if I want to open the Apple script and edit it, all I have to do is navigate to the script that I want to open and do Command O. So that's what that setting does. Okay, next I'm going to go to Universal Actions, previously File Actions, and my personal selection hotkey is F11, but you can change it to whatever you want. And for these Show Actions, I like to use the Function key, or you can use Control. So basically, if I search for test.scpt and I want to open up the Universal Actions panel, which is basically like right-clicking on something with the mouse, it just gives you a lot more options with what you can do. So I'm going to go ahead and try Function, and you can see that the universal actions show up. I'm going to go ahead and try that out with Control, and it does the same thing. And now I disable the right key, because when you do the right key, it'll go ahead and navigate towards the file path that it's at. So I kind of like that if I just want to navigate to the file. Now, what is universal actions good for? I really love it to move files. So let's say I download a font from fontfabric.com. So I'm going to go ahead and download the font, and then I'm going to navigate to it. And I want to go ahead and put this in my file catalog. Check out my video, How I Organize My Files. But essentially, I have an organized folder structure and a specific folder for fonts. I'm going to go ahead and open up that folder. So here's my main fonts folder. And so I want to put it inside of this folder. Now, normally, I could either go to my folder structure and find where the font folder is. Professional Resources Design Fonts. So that's a lot of clicking. And one reason why people's desktop and downloads folder kind of stays messy or cluttered is because filing it by hand takes too much time than just re-downloading it again. With Alfred, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the Universal Actions window to throw this zip file into a folder structure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 layers deep. So I'm going to go ahead and do my keyboard shortcut for activating Universal Actions. And then I'm going to start typing what I want to do, because there's a variety of commands here. So I'm going to move to, and then I'm going to search for the folder that I want to put it in. Now, I recently searched for fonts, so it just started to come up. So what I'm going to do is push enter, and you can see that it went from my downloads folder to my fonts folder. This is very, very powerful and an essential system of how I organize my files. I'm going to go ahead and do Command Z and put it back in the downloads folder. And let's go ahead and do some other things with universal actions. So I'm going to go ahead and do F11 and email 2. And then I'll type an email address, and it'll pull up your contacts if you have contacts enabled. And what it's going to do is going to open up mail and then automatically attach the file that I have into the new email. So also pretty useful. Another thing that I use a lot is going to a folder and then opening terminal at that path. So let's say I need to rebuild my website and publish it. I'm going to go to my website folder. It's 211 LC Public Library of Shea Luke. I'm going to push F11 to activate file actions, and I'm going to type terminal, and it's going to open up terminal at that path. So if I do ls, you can see all of the stuff that I have there, and then I can build my web files and go from there. Now iTerm opened up because I have a specific script for iTerm to open instead of terminal. I'll show you how to do that in the settings video. Cool. Now I'm going to show you clipboard history. This one is a super cool feature and I use it all of the time. So first example, let's say that I get an email with some FTP information and I want to copy it over to transmit. How I normally would do it is I would go ahead and copy the information and then go to my FTP program, paste it in, go back, copy, paste, go back, copy, paste. So that's a lot of back and forth. Another option that you can do is use clipboard history. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to select what I want and copy it, and it's going to put it on the clipboard history. I'm going to go ahead and copy the other options. And then I'm going to go ahead to my FTP program and I'm going to activate the clipboard history window. So for me, it's Option Command H, and you can see the three things that I pasted there. So I'm going to go ahead and just start typing to narrow the results. And it's going to go ahead and put it on the clipboard for me. And when I paste, it'll go ahead and paste what I want. And I'll go ahead and do this. So it's kind of more keystrokes, but it puts it all in one place. And the cool thing is, if you need this information later, it's on your clipboard history, so you can always go back to this information. Let's say 2 hours from now and you don't have the email open, you can find it. Now, another cool feature that I use clipboard history for is to send links that I just looked up to other friends or people. Now, what do I mean by that? Let's say I wanted to send a link of one of my videos to a friend. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy the URL and then I'll go to Slack or email it or share the link, however I wanna share it. Now let's say I wanna send it to another friend a couple hours later and I know that it was the last YouTube link that I copied. And what I can do in my new email is just go to clipboard history and then I'll search for YouTube and then paste it, and that'll be the last thing that I sent from YouTube. And it'll be in order. So I'm gonna go ahead and do Chrome again, and I'll click on a different video. And then if I go ahead and do Option Command H and type in YouTube, the most recent one is gonna be at the top. So I can always know that that was the most recent YouTube video. And for clipboard history, you just have to activate it here. And I like to do it as long as possible. Now, when you're copying passwords, there are some security risks. And if you need to clear your clipboard, all you have to do is do this. Go ahead and do Command Space Clear. And you can do it for the last 5 minutes, last 15, or the entire clipboard history. And then now when I open up the clipboard history, it's empty. So here are my settings for clipboard merging, and I'm gonna show you how it works. Okay, so let's say I have a couple things that I wanna copy. So 1, 2, 3. And then normally, let's say if I wanted to put these together. So what clipboard merging does is it puts multiple things on your clipboard together if you want. So I'm gonna go ahead and do Command C. And then I'm gonna go ahead and select the second thing that I want and do Command CC, so push it twice. And then you're gonna hear a little feedback noise. There we go. And so I'm gonna go ahead and paste what I just copied or merged, and it's gonna put the first thing that I copied and then a space and then the second thing. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it again, but I'm gonna do all three. So I'm gonna do Command C, it's always Command C, a single C the first time, and then two C's for each thing that you wanna add. So Command CC, Command CC, and then now it's gonna be 1, 2, 3. This is pretty cool. It comes in handy in certain situations, but it's really cool to have in your back pocket as a little shortcut. Okay, now I'm gonna show you how to create a custom keyboard shortcut for any application. One of the ones that I use a ton is to go back to the Finder because I'm always doing things and I wanna go back to where I was and not necessarily click on the Finder and open up a new window. I wanna see the most active window that was there when I was last using Finder. So I like to use Control F, and it's really accessible with your right hand. So like Control F, it's really an easy one. And you can see that the Finder popped up. Let's go ahead and walk through that shortcut together. So I'm gonna do Command Space, Command Comma, and I'm going to go to Workflows. Next, I'm gonna do Blank Workflow. It's just kind of easier to start off this way, and I'll call it Finder Example. And you can add the little Finder icon. If you search for finder.app, you can drag it in just to be neat. And then I'll go ahead and push create. I'm gonna right click or control click anywhere in the workflow area. And I'm going to do triggers. So basically you can choose what will initiate the program activating. So for the hotkey, I'm gonna do control F, and then I'm gonna do save. And then I'm going to tell it what I want to happen whenever control F is pressed. So I'm gonna right click again to get the contextual menu, and I'm gonna do actions and launch apps or files. Next, I'm gonna search for the app that I want to activate whenever this keyboard shortcut goes through. So I'm gonna do finder.app and drag it here and do toggle visibility for the apps if you want. That means if it's active and you want it to go away, you can just do the keyboard shortcut to make it go away, but I sometimes do that. So I'm gonna do save, and then the last step is to connect your trigger to your action. Now when I do control F, the Finder is gonna come to the top. Pretty cool. Next, I'm gonna show you how to sync your preferences over Dropbox with Alfred. I use Alfred on many different computers, so this really comes in handy. And whenever I add a new workflow or shortcut or anything or web search on another computer, it'll automatically sync with my other computer, so pretty handy. I'm gonna go to Advanced, and then right here where it says Set Preferences Folder, I'm going to navigate to somewhere on my Dropbox. So I already have it synced. It's pretty self-explanatory for that, so pretty cool. Next, I'm gonna walk you through a couple of my favorite workflows, and you can find them on pakl.org, and GitHub is a good place to search for Alfred workflows. You can just search Alfred, and then there's probably a ton that'll come up. Okay, the first one is Giphy. Sometimes I like to search for GIFs directly, and it's kind of a custom search, but it's just built in a workflow. So I'm gonna go ahead and type in the keyword for Giphy, and then I can do catnips. And it's gonna go ahead and search for your query. Another one that I like to do is AirDrop. So basically it'll just open up the AirDrop interface directly. It's just a quick shortcut. Another one is called Open Tabs, and this is pretty cool. Like, let's say here's a SoundCloud tab, but let's say I have a lot of tabs open and I want to jump to the SoundCloud tab from something else. So I'm going to do Command Space and type in Tabs, which is the trigger for the Open Tabs workflow, and I'm going to type SoundCloud. And so as soon as I see tabs, you can see that these three Chrome bookmarks are coming up. Those are the open tabs that I have open. I know I just repeated myself. But basically, you can then start to search for your tab if you know the particular one, and you could push enter and it'll open the particular program. Safari or Chrome, you can have both running and it'll search both programs and it'll pull it up to the front. Okay, now I'm gonna show you something that I call the magic 1-2 punch. Basically, it's a way that I copy the path of a file quickly to then open in a different program. So let's say I'm in Photoshop and I'm doing my design and I'm like, oh, I need a photo of me from a thumbnail. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use Alfred and I'm gonna go to the file that I want. Let's say I need my logo. So I'm gonna go ahead and go to my logo. And then here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna copy the path and then use the path to import it into Photoshop just using the keyboard. I know you could drag and drop, but I hate dragging and moving, so I'm a keyboard person, if you haven't determined that already. So I'm gonna do F11 for universal actions, and I'm going to type in copy, and then it'll have copy to or copy path to clipboard. I'm gonna go down to copy path to clipboard. Then I'm gonna go back to Photoshop, do my keyboard shortcut for place, Shift Command D. And so here you see that the location of the import window is in a totally different place than where I would want it to be. So I'm gonna do Shift Command G, then I'm gonna do Command V, because that's the path that I just copied, and push enter, and it's gonna navigate directly to the file that I want. I'll push enter, and boom. So it's a pretty cool way to find something in the Finder, copy the path, and then put it in the program that you want with just using the keyboard. Okay, so this is one of my favorite workflows ever. And basically what it does is it automatically identifies the last file that you just downloaded, which is pretty cool. Let's say you have a ton of stuff there and you downloaded a bunch of fonts and you want to find the last one. So I went ahead and downloaded a couple things, and I'm going to download something else, and we're going to jump right to it from the browser. So let's say I'm gonna go ahead and download this one. And now that it's downloaded, I'm gonna do the keyboard shortcut Control Option L. So it's the two ones to the right of Command and then L. The reason that I like to use L is because it's the default keyboard shortcut for downloads. If you go here, the downloads folder is Option Command L, L's for downloads. Okay, so here we go. So you see that it was download, it's the last item here. So I'm gonna go back to the browser and do Control Option L, and it should highlight the last one. Boom, so it just highlighted the workflow that we just downloaded. Now I set up another keyboard shortcut, and I'll provide this one. So basically, instead of Control Option side by side to reveal, you can do Shift Control, the one on top, to go ahead and open it directly from the browser. So if you have a huge list of things, you can just open it right up. So I'm gonna go back to the browser and do Shift Control L, and it's gonna open up the last thing that I downloaded. Pretty cool. So if you're like downloading a logo and you wanna use it right away and you need to pull it from Illustrator, you can just do Control Shift L and it'll open up. Now I also have a set for the desktop. So instead of L, I just put D. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a screenshot, and then I want to navigate directly to it. So I'm gonna do Control Option side by side, D, and it's gonna highlight the last screenshot that I took. Now let's say I wanted to just open it up. I'm gonna do Shift Control D, and it'll open it up, boom, right away. Super, super cool. Another one that I use a lot is the time zone workflow. So you can just do TZ, and then you can have a list of time zones that you currently use. So if I wanna say, oh, what time is it? Whenever it's 5 o'clock here, what time is it gonna be in London? So I'm gonna go ahead and do TZ and type in 5, and it's gonna convert the New York time, my current time zone, to all of the other time zones. That's pretty cool. And then there's some more cool things that you can do with that. Another cool thing, if you have one password, see my video, How I Manage My Passwords, you can link one password with Alfred. Basically, you go to Features, and you click on One Password, and you do Enable One Password Bookmarks, and then once you enable it, I'm gonna go ahead and click it, and then cut away. Once you enable it, you can then search for your One Password Bookmarks, and then it'll automatically open up and then fill in the password for you. So I'm gonna do the one for fonts.com, I'll put in my master password, and then it's gonna automatically open up and then insert my information inside. Super cool. Okay, so that's it for my favorite Power Pack features. In the next video, I'm just going to run through every setting and talk about it in the spirit of slow jams. And then if you have any questions or specific things, you can go to that particular video or chapter in the video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.